From VOA, Learning English, this is the Education Report. Choosing the right college is very important to students and their families. They look at rankings or lists of schools to make that choice. But rankings are not as simple as they seem. U.S. News and World Report uses information from more than 1,000 schools to create a list of the top universities. The Princeton Review and Forbes are also well-known lists that rank schools. U.S. News and World Report measures selectivity. Selectivity means that the school accepts a small percent of applicants. The applicants must have excellent academic records and very high test scores. The problem, says education expert Jonathan Rothwell, is that schools that are selective may benefit from better students. It does not mean that they provide the best education. Stacy Berg Dale and Alan B. Kruger are researchers. They looked at two groups of students with similar test scores. One group could have gone to the selective schools, but they chose to attend schools that were less selective. That group of students still made the same amount of money as the students who went to the selective schools. This suggests that it is the student, not the school, that creates the success. In 2013, the U.S. Department of Education announced a new plan for ranking colleges. It looks at the annual cost after financial aid, the school's graduation rate, and the annual salary for graduates. The Obama administration's goal is to give students information to help them choose the school that is right for them and avoid unnecessary loans. For VOA Learning English, I'm Jonathan Evans.